soldiers opened fire at angry villages. You're welcome to the news. That is the news to do. That is the news headline. Now to the news to do. Bite Bridge police and some Hamming officers on Friday allegedly opened fire at Makakaville villages after two of their colleagues were manhandled following an agreement about an armed robbery of 15,000 by security agents. At the time of publishing, there had been no reports of deaths or injuries from the shooting. Police spokesman, Assistant Commissioner Paul Inyati said investigations were underway and would provide more details later. I am yet to get full details, but investigations are underway, he said. A villager identified only as Tembani said he was at a funeral when a relative claiming to have been robbed by policemen and a soldier accompanied by two civilians called. I found the soldier and policeman firing guns in the air, and I called Bit Bridge police, who directed me to another senior policeman, Assistant Commissioner Cosmos Masepa, who said he was deploying another team, said Tembani. The officer in charge of Bit Bridge Police District, Chief Superintendent Techano Unyango, confirmed receiving a call from Tembani, but said he directed him to Masepa. I heard the report and I referred Tembani to Assistant Commissioner Masepa, he said. The police and the soldiers, they opened fire at hungry villages. And someone said that there was an argument about an alleged robbery. And he saw that the policeman and the soldier accompanied by two civilians. The soldier and the policeman were firing guns in the air. And he called on the police, who directed him to another senior policeman. And this was confirmed by the other policeman. This is happening in Zimbabwe. This is coming when Malima said, I would rather also die than letting hungry Zimbabweans die alone. South Africa's opposition economic freedom fighters, EFF, Commander-in-Chief Julius Malema says he would rather die or resign from politics than support the xenophobic expulsion of Africans from the country. The firebrand opposition leader was responding to questions from the media if his militant stance in support of foreigners had led the economic freedom fighters, EFF, to lose in the recent local council elections. However, Malami said it was xenophobic to demand foreigners to leave South Africa. Millions of Africans have settled in South Africa in search of better opportunities in the continent's biggest economy. It is very xenophobic to say foreigners must leave. I am prepared to go home. I am fine. I will never take part in a platform and denounce Africans. I will never do it, Malami told the media on Tuesday. If it means votes are going, let them go. I am prepared to go home. But to take a platform, and please, the white minority, by pointing a finger at my fellow African brothers, I am not going to do that. When I see in Nigeria, in Zimbabwe, Congolese or Ghanaian, I say myself. He added, so I must go and tell hungry Zimbabweans to live here and go here to die. I would rather die with them than allow them to die alone. I am not prepared to take a platform and say foreigners must go home. I would rather not be the president of South Africa. I will be my children's president, practicing cabinet there. If that thing has cost us municipalities and there are people who say, I must resign, I will resign. Please be aware that the stance on African remains. It goes nowhere. You are asking me to compromise on non-negotiable cardinal pillars of the EFF. I cannot do that. Malima has been a leading voice against xenophobia in South Africa. His scourge that has claimed hundreds of black lives whenever violence broke out. Malima has said that he would rather die than let hungry Zimbabweans die alone. But why this xenophobic agitation? He cannot allow foreigners to leave. I am prepared to go home. I am fine. I will never take part in a platform and denounce Africans. I will never do that. Malima said, must I go and tell hungry Zimbabwe to leave here and go here to die? I would rather die with them than allow them to die alone. In the first news, the police and soldiers were seen opening fire at angry villagers. And when a correspondent saw them, he quickly called on the police to come and take charge of the scene. Thank you for always tuning with us. Do have a blessed day.